हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? वेलकम टू मेहदी इंग्लिश स्कूल. माई सेल्फ नीलोफर मिस एंड माई सब्जेक्ट इज मैथमेटिक्स दैट यू ऑल नो राइट. एंड माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस ऑनलाइन सेशन इज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 2. सो आई होप दैट यू ऑल आर रेडी टू अटेंड दिस ऑनलाइन सेशन टूडेज. ओके, so as you know that we always read the quote first before we start our today's online session. So here is the quote that study hard and see the magic. What? If you want to see, here you have to take the magic as the rank, as the percentage. Study hard and see how much percentage you will get in the exam. That is the magic. Hard work, if you do hard work, you will get the good result as a magic. Okay, now we are in the chapter number 10, which is measurement. Okay, so let's do revision first of the previous lecture and then we are moving to the current topic. So here is the today's previous revision first. So let's do it. So the revision of the previous topic is complete now. So let's move to the today's topic, which one is a new topic. So let's read the heading first. So here is the heading, the measurement. As you know, the name of the chapter number 10, and heavier and light. We are doing the weight worksheet. Okay, heavy and light. So the name of this worksheet is heavier and lighter. See, here is the things and here is the things. These two things are given, and here is the all the things are heavier thing, and here the all the things are lighter thing. And if you compare the one row of the things, so you can easily understood one is a heavy and one is a small. So here is an elephant. So as you know, elephant is a very big animal, right? So you can write down H, because elephant is a heavier animal, and here is a rat, right? And you know this mouse as a this know this rat as a Jerry, right? The Tom and Jerry cartoon, this mouse, this rat will come as a Jerry, right? So here is the elephant, which is very heavy, and here is the rat, which is compared to light elephant, right? So this way you can compare the things with each other. Okay, now here is a truck and here is a car. So if you compare these two things, truck and car, so you can easily compare the things that which one is more heavier and which one is lighter with compared to other. Okay, so here is truck. So truck is heavier than the car. So you can write down H in front of the truck, and you can write down L for lighter in front of the car. So if you compare these two things with each other, truck and car, so truck is more heavier and car is a lighter with the compare of truck. Now here is the two balls. One is a basketball and one is a tennis ball. Two balls are there. Okay, so if you compare these two balls with each other, so which one is a heavier, which one is a lighter? Do you have any idea? So students, this one H for heavier, so this ball is a heavier, and that tennis ball that all the children will play the cricket with this ball, so this is a lighter ball. Now you have to give the heading in the fair book. This way on the new page you have to write down this heading. You have to give heading into your fair book. Some of you, when came to the meeting, they took the fair book with them to checking. So some of the students are there, they are making two good books. They are making very good handwriting book, right? They are maintaining fair book very well. So I appreciate them, those who are making the fair book. So those who are not making still, so they can start with exercise 10B only. So here is the exercise 10B, and you have to give this heading into the fair book. And just keep this in your mind, that start writing with a new page. Give this heading to the new page only. Write down this way, exercise 10B, and this way, give the question number. So exercise 10B and the question number 1. You have to give the heading this way, exercise 10B and the question number 1. So let's start this. Now this one is a instruction for this question. What is this? This one is an instruction. We have to follow this instruction. It is compulsory to follow this. So you have to write down this instruction into your fair book, and this is compulsory to write. I will give you the time to write down this. So let's read it. Are these objects light or heavy? Some objects are given in the picture. I will show you in the next slide. So if that given objects are light or heavy, decide. You have to decide whether you would weight them in a gram or kilogram. So the lighter things you have to measure in the gram, or the heavy thing you have to measure in the kilogram. Okay, students. So I'll give you just half minute right now to write down this all the things. You have a half minute. So please write down this exercise 10B, then the question number 1, and here is the instruction for it. Just write it down, the instruction, and this is the compulsory to write down this instruction. Some pictures is given, so I'll show you the pictures first, and you have to write down this instruction in the fair book. That is compulsory for you all. Now here is the textbook exercise I have for you. You can see this picture, and this is your textbook exercise, students. So here, as I told you, this is exercise 10B, and here is the question 1. And this one is the instruction. Are these objects light or heavy? Decide whether you would weigh them in a gram or a kilogram. So here, as per the question, here the pictures are given. Here is the slab of chocolate. So here the slab of chocolate is given, that how it looks. So you can at least imagine, so how heavy or light the object is. That's why the picture is given also. So the first one, let's take the A, question number A we are taking first. A slab of chocolates. Here is the picture of chocolate. Here is number A and the picture of chocolate you can see here, right? So you all love chocolates, right, students? So chocolate is a very heavy thing, right? Or not? No, chocolate is not that much heavy thing. It is a lighter thing. You can easily just put into your pocket, right? Not only a one chocolate you can put. You can put so many chocolates into your pocket and you will not feel that chocolate is a heavy thing, right? So here is the answer box is given. So we have to write down gram or kilogram. So chocolate you can measure in the gram only, because that is not as much heavy as we can just measure in the kilogram. So a slab of chocolate we can measure in the gram. So if you have textbook, just write down gram in this answer box. And if you don't have textbook, just write down this sentence, A, slab of chocolate, and in front of the box is that, and you can write down the gram. Just g, small g, as here the given. Now number B. So now number B is there, a sheet of paper. So what is the meaning of a sheet of a paper? Here the picture is given. The sheet of paper, it means just a paper of your notebook. See this, the blank paper, as you are making so many things from your book, right? You are just take a page from your book, a single page. We are talking about this single page, right? We are in number B. So here is the page. So you can just make so many things, aeroplane and all the toys, chit chat, you are making from this page, right? So page is not that much heavy thing, so you have to measure it in the kilogram, okay? A sheet of paper you have to measure in the gram only. So if you have a textbook, just write down in the number B, gram. Or you don't have, then just write down in a fair book this way. And you, they have a both the things, so you can write down in a both the books, fair and textbook. A sheet of a paper, so you have to write down in the answer box G. Then number C is there, a suitcase filled with clothes. So whenever you have to go for a vacation or mama's house, right, nanny's home, so this one is a suitcase. Whenever you want to go outside of your home for 5 to 6 days or one day, you are, what you are doing first, you are pack your bag first, right? Because you have to go outside and you all the necessary things you will carry with you. So just these clothes and all the things you will put in this types of suitcase bag, right? So this is filled with clothes. So whenever you are putting all the things, clothes and all the things in one bag, so it will become a very heavy. You cannot easily just carry it or just pull it or push it, okay? So whenever a suitcase filled with clothes, we are not talking about the empty suitcase, okay? We are talking about the suitcase which is filled with clothes, okay? So here is, we can measure the filled with clothes suitcase in the kilogram. We can measure the suitcase which is filled with full of clothes and the so many other things. So we can measure in the kilogram. Then a sack of potatoes. What? Number D is a sack of potatoes. Here I am showing you what is the meaning of sack. So you can call it a sack. Here number D, you can see here, this one is a sack and filled with the potatoes, right? This one, this bag, you can see it. This one, you can call it a sack and it is filled with the potatoes. So here is the full of sack we are talking about and it is filled with the potatoes. A sack of potatoes, okay? So potatoes is a very heavy thing which is together, which is fully sack. Sack of potatoes we are talking about. So sack of potatoes is a very heavy thing. That object is a heavy object. So we have to write down kilogram. Because that one, number D, a sack of potato, here you can see the picture, is a very heavy thing. So you have to write down kilogram because you will measure in the kilogram. Whenever you have to measure this types of heavy thing, so the weight will come in the kilogram, okay? Now the next one is an auto rickshaw. See, you all know about this auto rickshaw. See this, here the picture of the auto rickshaw is given here in number E. See this, this picture is given, okay? So you all are know about the auto rickshaw, right? You are coming to school in the auto rickshaw even, right? How you come to school? Some will come by themselves, by walk they come. They are just staying near to school, so they will come to school by walk. And some, they are staying so far from school, so they will come by auto. Right, here is the auto rickshaw. So they will come by the auto. So auto is filled with so many people and students. So auto is not then lighter things, right? So we cannot measure in a gram because that auto rickshaw is not a lighter thing. It is a heavier thing. So you can measure in the kilogram. And auto rickshaw, you can measure in the kilogram. Now number F, a comb. We are talking about the hair comb. Here is, you can see this hair comb, you can see, which is in a blue color. So we are using the comb to combing our hair, right? So that is also a very light thing. We can just easily take it by our one hand only, by the fingers only, right? So this one is also a lighter thing that is not that much heavy. So we can measure the comb in the graph. We can decide that I will measure this comb in a gram. Now a knife, here is number G. See this, here is the knife we are using to cut the vegetables, fruits and bread or another things we are using to, we are use this knife to cut. So knife is also a very light thing, okay. Now you can just write down a knife and just write down gram. A packet of biscuit, see this, right, here is the packet of biscuit, I'll show you in the number H. So students, you are easily put the packet of biscuit into your pocket, okay, right? So the pocket of the biscuit is not as much heavy, so we have to measure in the kilogram. This is very lighter thing, you can easily put into your, even child or children can put this types of biscuit packets in the pocket, their pocket, right? So that is not as much heavy, so we can measure it in the gram. So please write down this exercise into the fair book, students, that is compulsory for you all. Now the revision is complete of the previous topic, okay. So today's new topic is a time. The name of this chapter is a time. So what do you think, students, what is time? Here is my question. You can see, what is a time? We all are doing all the things on time, okay. Everything must done on the time, right? You are coming to school on time, right? You are doing homework on time. The particular time is given for particular things. Homework time is different, sleeping time is different, right? So eating time is different. Every time is different for everyone. Your eating time should not match with my eating time, right? Everyone's time must be a different. It is not a same thing. Everyone has a different things and they have to do at the different time. Okay, no need to say you what is time, right? If you want to know the time, we are looking at the clock, right? Where we are looking, and everyone's home, there is a clock, right? Wall clock, you are wearing the clock. That is very important part in our life, is a time. Without timing, we are not doing anything. Everything must go on with the help of time. So time is a big thing, and in the second standard I will going to teach you how to see time, how to know time, what time is it. Whenever you are in the class, when you came to school, right? So what do you ask to teacher? How many minutes left for recess, right? What you are asking me? That ma'am, how much minutes are left for recess? How much time left for living? When is the living time? Right? All the things you are asking me. So all the things depends on the time. All the teachers are taking the lectures on time. Right? Recess is there, but at the specific time. Right, students? So time is a very important part of our life. So let's see about the time. Now see, this types of digital clocks is also available in the market, okay. Two clocks is there, one is an analog and one is a digital clock. So this types of clocks you have seen somewhere. If you remember, just observe around it to you, someone's home, this types of clock is there, someone's home analog clock is there. Even into your mobile, if you check the home screen or lock screen, you can see these types of minutes and hour, right? So time is must there, because all the things is depends on time. Time is a money one type of. So many times I written the quote, time is money. Okay, this types of quote I written on the board. So this is the very true quote is there. Now here you can see what this girl is doing. She try to stop the time. She wants to hold the time, but time is not wait for anything. Anything happens, but time is not wait for anything. It running on its way. Okay, it is not wait for anyone. Anything is there. Time is not wait for us. We have to wait for time, but time is not wait for us. So I have some questions for you students. So just tell me, this is the basic questions. Okay, when you go to school, it means when you come to school. I am in the school right now, but where, when the, just forget this corona days and lockdown days, just tell me when the normal days were there. So at what time you came to school? Do you remember what is the time of our school? Yeah, you forget it. Yes, I know you remember the time of the school. Your school is afternoon school, right? You are not coming school to the morning timings. You are coming to school in the afternoon, right? But what time I am asking to you a time. So what is your answer? Just speak your answer, then I will show you the my answer. Just tell me your answer. What is your answer? Just speak into your mind. And I hope your answer will match with my answer. Okay? So when you go to school, it means when you come to school. So the answer is 12:30 p.m. Right? Your school timing is 12:30. 12:30. This is your school timing, right? Coming time. Entry time. Okay? This is your entry time. Okay? So that is very important things for us to discuss. You all know this, right? That is the time of your school. This is the time limit. You have to reach to school at 12:30. In between 12 to 12:30, right? Now the next question I have for you. You all are waiting for this time when you come to school, when you are in the class. You are waiting for the break or recess time. Right? So what is your break time or recess time? What is? You all are waiting for it. You are asking me, ma'am, how much minutes are left for recess? How much minutes? And you are asking me that, ma'am, we are very hungry. When recess will go on? Right? So what is the recess time? Do you remember? You forgot. So when you come to school, four lectures is done, and after four lectures there will be a recess, right? So what is the time exactly? At what time recess is there? So recess is there at 3 o'clock. When the recess is go? Recess is on 3 o'clock. Okay, when the 3 o'clock is there, the recess is there. That is the recess time, 3 to 3:20. Okay. Now the next question I have for you, what is your leaving time? It means the going home time after school. What is the last period? At what time the leaving bell is ringing? At what time? Do you remember, students, at what time the bell is rang? That is the long bell, and you all are just love that bell. You are all are waiting for that bell. That bell is ringing and we are going to horn, right? So the time of leaving of the school is 5:30. 5:30 is the time for leaving. Okay, now the next question I have for you, how much minutes you get for recess? What? How much time you got for the recess? How much minutes you will get? and when you came to school, you are at the school, how much minutes you were get for the recess, for taking lunch, for eating your snacks, how much minutes you are getting? So the recess is 20 minutes long, just or 20 minutes you are getting for the recess, for the break, for the refreshment, how much minutes you are getting? You are getting just or 20 minutes for the recess in our school. We are talking about our school, okay? We are not talking about any other school. We are talking about the our school only. Now the next one is, how many numbers are in the clock? If you observe the clocks, there is some numbers are there. So anyone is just see the clock, can you observe the clock that how many numbers are there? If you have clock, if you are just sitting at your home, just check the clock that how many numbers are there in the clock. Have you imagined somewhere before we are discussing about the time? Do you know how many numbers are in the clock is written? How many numbers, how many hands are there? Okay, so if you don't know, I'll see you the answer. I'll give you the answer. I'll show you the answer. See this, here is one clock I'm showing you in this picture. So if you start with the one, see how many numbers are there in the clock. You can see here the clock is very good visible. Here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. How many numbers are in the clock? So what is your answer? There are 12 numbers in the clock. How many? It must ask as a FA4 exams. If you properly watch the videos, so you are able to give the answer, you are able to just, you know, get the full marks. Okay? Some questions may be asked from the videos also. So that is compulsory to watch the videos. Now, and this is the common questions. How many numbers in the clock? So you can see very well, 12 numbers are available in the clock. Now, what is time? See, here some words are there for speaking the time. See this. This is just for information. We are not discussing this slide right now. We are discussing after explaining the time. Okay. So, just we ignore it. See this. 8 a.m. It means the morning. Sun is there. You can see sun is there. This is the 8 a.m. So it is time for school. We are talking about the morning school. See, this boy is going for school. He is waiting for the bus. And here is 8 o'clock. 8 and 00. So he'll go to school. Then 1 o'clock. See this. He's taking his lunch. What he is taking? At 1 o'clock, he is taking his lunch. Then at the 6 o'clock, see, he is playing time. You all have that, your all playing time, right? Your mama, your parents give you the playing time also. See this, this clock is showing the 6 o'clock in this picture. And this boy's playing time is the 6 o'clock, right? See, this boy is sleeping. Here, outside from the window, you can see the moon also, right? And at the 10 o'clock, the boy is going to sleep. The boy is at in his bed. Okay. So we all are doing our routine with the time. With time, we are doing our things. Okay. See, I have one more thing. One more picture I have for you. See, this boy is just going for bath. Right? This girl is brushing her teeth. This girl is in her bed right now. This boy is reading something. So, every activity we are doing at our own time, right? Right now this is the corona timing, okay, lockdown timing is there. So our timetable of routine is must be a different from each other. Not everyone is going to take the lunch at 1 o'clock. Someone is taking 12 o'clock, they are taking their lunch at 12 o'clock, someone is taking their lunch at 1 o'clock, someone is taking the lunch at 2 o'clock, right? All the people are following the different times. So this is the main thing to just explain about the time. See this, here one chart is there. We all are doing these things on the time. First of all, we are just getting up, okay? Then we are brushing the teeth, eating snack, doing some exercise, reading time, playing time. Just see this. Make your room clean, going to bath, going to bed. So this is our routine circle. We are just following this circle, right? So this way, all have their different routines. Someone's sleeping time is 10 o'clock, someone's sleeping time is 11, 12, as per their whom, right? So this is the thing, students. And all have their different timings. So we are all working on the time only. We all have our time, right? Then the next one. Here I'll just show you the one picture about this girl. See this. We all are doing our activities on time. Bathing time, eating time, playing time, tuition time, painting time. Someone likes paint a lot. So here is a painting time. Here is a reading time. Here is a sleeping time. Here is gaming time. Here is a bathing time. So everyone is following their routine of the time. So time is a different thing. We have to follow the times. If we miss the time, we miss our activity, our routine, daily routine we miss, right? We mash our routine. You know, if you just miss one point, if you miss bathing, so the next step is there, eating. If you just miss this point, the next point is there. So we have to follow the time. Time will not follow us, but we have to follow the time. That is compulsory. So I hope that is some just summary is there of the time. We'll discuss some more thing about the time, but in the next lecture. So you just try to just taking some information from your parents that how to see in the clock. What time is it? Just try it and let's discuss in the next lecture. Okay, students. So, thank you so much, students, for watching this video. Now, stay home, stay safe. We'll meet with some new worksheet in the next lecture. So, bye-bye.